stage, Mickey, Davey, and Peter, the Monkees!
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Good night. Good night. No. Thanks for coming.
No, Mickey. No, no, no. No, no. No, it's all right.
More?
Yeah, there is more. We've got a lot more to do, yes.
We haven't done our
I got a date.
We're already a week late, okay? Come on. I can handle him, okay? Hold on. Now, listen. We've only just started, okay?
Okay.
You remember?
Okay.
You're going to be okay tonight?
Okay, Davey. Okay.
He's okay. So what? What the heck have you all been doing for the last 37 years? Oh, really?
Having children.
Yeah, that's the way to go. You know, I have four daughters, all girls. Yeah. When you're the father of boys, you worry. But when you're the father of girls, you pray.
And you know this because?
For he was once a boy.
And still am, for the most part.
Yes, we used to be a boy band, didn't we?
Oh, yes, we did. We're a boy band.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what. We've got lots of songs to sing for you tonight. We've had lots and lots of requests, but we're going to sing anyway, okay?
Any Monkey fans out there?
Okay. Oh, good.
We're going to carry on with a song that we started and ended off second season with, a song written by H. Torkelson. This one is called For Pete's Sake.
Thank you.
It makes me feel so good. And I wanna live without her, even if I could. Valerie,
I love her.
Valerie. Oh yeah, come on now, yeah. Wow. Oh.
I had the pleasure of going over to England and meeting the members of another group. They were called the Beatles. I wonder whatever happened to them. One night they threw us a party. Now, I don't remember much about the party. I'm told I had a great time. But after the party, I wrote this song, and I do remember that. I hope.
Done. We're
Stop,
finished. It's all
done.
The colors!
Hey!
The colors!
Don't go punching. It's not a mosh pit.
Okay,
you
Mickey,
know.
You're fine now. Okay, Mickey, look. It's your pals here. It's Peter and David here. We're okay now. You're okay.
Who the hell are you? Hey, it's the monkeys.
Yeah.
Hey, where's that other guy with a hat whose mother invented liquid paper?
Mike Nesmith.
He's gone.
Now, come on. It's okay. Look, is there anything I can get you at all?
Yeah, Prozac and gin malt.
Prozac.
You mean all he has to do is raise his arms, he gets a round of applause like that?
Cool.
Everybody having a good time? Well, we'll soon fix that. We want to thank those of you, particularly those of you who are here tonight, and you know who you are.
I'm here!
Those of you who are not here, eat dirt. It's always fun to abuse the absent, isn't it? Those of you who have been following closely the history of this group of ours may have noticed that I personally did not sing lead on a lot of the tunes that we did.
Oh, Peter.
Hi. It was a whopper. It was an Anaheim special, that one. Wait a minute. Got it.
We're going to do a song that I did sing lead on now. And I'm a little of mixed feelings about your applause, because what it really means is that you know there was only one, you know which one it was. But that's okay, I'm not complaining. It's a nasty song about a relative of yours. You don't come off so good either. I'm going to start now if these guys are done messing about. One, two, three, four. I love to count.
She knows her mind all right, your Auntie Zelda. She says she knows my kind, she might maybe so. Boy, yeah, she's raised to right. Zelda, you only know the things she wants you to know. I know she's having a fit, she doesn't like me one little bit. No bird of grace ever lit on Antigua Zelda. You can't begrudge her style, your Antigua Zelda. She couldn't budge a smile and do it for free. So righteous making fudge, your Antigua Zelda. So proper judging others over her tea. I know she's having a fit. She doesn't like my butt. No bird of grace ever lit on Auntie Zelda. Like Auntie Zelda, it takes much more to be someone of your own. You've got to make it free from Auntie Zelda, or just like her, you'll have to make it alone. You look just like her, you do. I know by looking at you that you've been listening to your Auntie Zelda.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And now, I'd like to take you back to yesteryear. Yesterdecade, actually. Even further back than that, if the truth be known. I'd like to take you back to Malibu Beach, 1966. To those heady, heady days of the 60s. They say if you remember the 60s, you weren't really there. But who knew? I'd like to sing a song written by Mr. Tommy Boyce and Mr. Bobby Hart. Who were you kissing when this song was number one? Isn't it amazing when you get older how you can lie with a straight face? This song was never number one. I just said that, I thought. Is this on?
I wanna be free, like the bluebirds, flying by me, like the waves out on the blue. If your love has its eye on me, don't try me. Say goodbye. I wanna be free. Don't say you love me. Say you like me. 90s you beside me. Stay close enough to guide me, fighting me. Whoa, whoa.
Myself if I didn't sing at least one of my own songs tonight. I've actually written over 200 songs, and that was just this morning. Are you sure this is on? You know, when I'm walking around, we're all out in the town every day and checking things out, and people point at us and say things like, "Do you know who you are?" I usually tell a lie. So yeah, I'm Dudley Moore, and it's nice, isn't it? Yeah, lovely. What do you mean you're a hooker? I thought I was doing so well with you. Yeah, 10. Yeah, right. Also, I get girls coming up to me, and a couple of fellas. They tell me that when the Monkey Show was on, they used to keep our picture on their bedroom wall. Right. And I bet you used to turn it around when you were getting ready for bed, didn't you? And not only that, I'm told that when the Monkey Show was on, you used to go over there and kiss the television, right? It was very, very dangerous in the 60s to do that, because we had those electrified carpets. Do you remember those? And you walked across the room and you kissed the TV and you flew 15 feet back. Now, I know this is true because I got third-degree burns from watching I Dream a Genie, okay? I'd like to dedicate this song to all the girls and some of the guys that said they'd love me forever, especially my four daughters, Jessica, Annabelle, Talia, and Sarah. It's called I'll Love You Forever. I'll love you this year. I'll love you next year. And then forever. I'll always need you. I'll never leave you. I'll love you forever. And if you ever change your mind, think again. You're my first love. You are my last love. You're my forever. I love this feeling. My heart is beating a mile a minute. No other woman ever been so deep inside in it. Oh, when the sun shines on our love, that's when I thank the Lord above for you're my first love. You are my last love. My beginning. Come on, man. and my forever. Come on, Aviva, play my song.
We're going to do a song now from the Monkey movie, Head. You know, thank you very much. Don't let me discourage anybody from yelling, but you know, it's just that I have a piece of that. In fact, they gave me a piece of the movie in lieu of a salary. And that's more people than they told me came to see the movie and rented it on video and DVD, all put combined. What I want to know is, where was my accountant when I needed him?
He's probably in Bermuda right now, actually.
Bermuda, huh? Yeah. Enjoying the sun, you think?
And your money, mate.
All right. Well, as long as somebody is.
And
I just want to know, you know, that's all I care about. Okay, so here goes the song in question, which... What was the question?
Can you dig it? Do you know? Would you care?
All right, now that's a song, as Peter said, written for the movie Head, which starred all kind of people, didn't it, you know? It was a Victor Mature was in that movie, and Carol Doda was in that movie, and lots of other people. We were in it, Mickey, Mikey, Petey, and Davey, we were all in it, weren't we? And Peter was right, we didn't get paid for that either, but it's not dollars and cents at the end of the day. It's all about us, isn't it? It's all about a good old song. You know, I travel around and I meet so many people as I travel, because I do a lot of walking around town, checking things out, seeing what's going on. And there's three little words that follow me no matter where I go. I could be walking down the street in Detroit or in LA or in Anaheim, and all of a sudden I hear, Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. I did one episode of the Brady Bunch show, okay? That was just one. It was like a long time ago. Most people think that I married Marsha Brady, you know. They think we moved to Ohio and had six kids, but we never even did the noughties, you know? No, we didn't. Most people think we did, but we didn't do the noughties. I think I was like 20 years old. I think she was like 15 or something like that. Well, that would have got me 25, wouldn't it? I'd just be coming out next week. Mind you, after reading that Brady Bunch book, wow, I missed out, I'll tell you that. They were all at it. And I was stuck with Mickey, Mikey, and Petey, you know? Thank goodness I came out in one piece out of that lot, I'll tell you. Anyway, what we thought would be nice tonight, we thought, be good to sing a song that I sang to Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. Well, actually, let me just tell you something. What you don't know is that I was asked by Marsha, 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 who was the president of my fan club at the time. So the script said, anyway. I was asked to sing at her prom, and what you don't know is I got hate letters from every other girl in America because I wouldn't go to their bloody prom. And you know that little dance that I used to do like that? I still do it. No, actually, I was telling you about my four daughters. Well, my youngest one, we were watching the reruns of the Monkees the other day, and she said to me, Dad, and I was up there doing the Davy Jones, right? She says, Dad, why are you dancing like Axl Rose? I swear, she did. I said, been there, done that, got the T-shirt. So you ready for this one? Okay, here's a song. I sang to Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. And I'd sing it to her again if I had to.
That way.
David Jones, ladies and gentlemen.
Davy Jones, the face.
Yeah, the face. You know.
You know, in Greek mythology, there's a story of Helen of Troy, who had a face that launched 1,000 ships. Well, Davy Jones is the face that shipped 1,000 lunchboxes.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hey, Peter, what's that you got strapped on there?
My ethnic instrument.
No, the banjo.
The five-string banjo, the guy with this little thing here, the fifth-string peg, which is, it's not a tumor at all. The fifth-string peg makes the banjo do different kinds of things than the other banjo did. This banjo now goes...
David, remind me never to go river rafting with Peter.
So we're going to do something else.
To the old virtual eights for my favorite part of the show. You know, we had a lot of great songwriters writing for us back in the old days.
Yeah, we did.
We had Carole King.
Carole King.
Neil Diamond.
Neil Sedaka.
Neil Sedaka. Harry Nielsen.
Paul Williams.
Paul Williams.
Boyce and Hart.
Barry Mann and Cynthia Wilde.
Lieber and Stoller.
Lieber and Stoller.
Barry Mann and Cynthia Wilde.
Sears and Roebuck.
Barnes Sears and Roebuck.
Lord and Taylor.
Barnes and Noble. But wait a minute.
Neiman Marcus.
Hey.
What?
Serious here.
I'm getting excited.
Because.
What?
We're now going to take you back. Not 3 decades, but 30 decades.
30?
Yes, 30 decades. That's 300 years for those of you that can multiply. And I suppose it's 300 years for those of you that can't, too. Either way. Yes, we're going to take you back.
Will I be able to see?
Yes, you'll be.
Okay.
Will I be able to play the violin?
No, you won't.
Okay.
You're never good anyway.
I've never played the violin before.
With the aid of this garment that is winging its way on the stage as we speak, Mr. Peter H. Torkelson will now perform for you the two-part invention number 8 in F by that great songwriter of his time, Mr. Johann Sebastian Bach. Otherwise known to his friends as, you didn't know this probably, Puff Buck. Then he changed it to Josie Daddy Buck.
No, it wasn't Josie or Puff Buck.
Boom. Come, Puffy Buck.
Stop messing around.
Joe Daddy Buck.
This is the serious part of the show. Mickey, stop it. Peter, I'm with you all the way.
Thank you, David.
You carry
Thank
on.
You very
I'm
much.
Right
Thank
there
you.
With you, man. You bark away. Go ahead.
Thank you.
Well, thanks very much. And thanks to Matthew for that. We're going to do another song from the movie
Hit.
Which, thanks, Mom. This is a song who's got a couple of different titles. The short title is Long Title, and the long title is Interminable. That's not it, it's just a description. It's just very, very long, so. I guess I should, before you guys have to shave again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1!
So fine, yeah.
No way, this is going on eBay. I'd like to say hi to a couple of people in the audience also. I have two daughters here myself, Amy and Emily. I don't know where they are actually, but yeah, having teenage daughters, it's God's punishment for having sex. This is the part of the show where we traditionally take you back into our respective pasts to give you some idea where we came from musically and geographically. I came from Los Angeles, born and raised, where they say everybody's like a granola bar, either fruits, nuts, or flaky. I'm the one that's nuts. Thank you very much. Thank you. My mom and dad were both singers. My mom was a singer in the big band era and sang the blues also. My dad sang light opera as opposed to heavy opera, I guess. I'd be watching television, watching Superman or something, and he'd come walking through the living room going, "Some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger." I'd go, "Dad, Superman's about ready to kill somebody. Leave me alone." My mom was also a singer, like I say. And before the Monkees, I actually did have a life. I had another group, one called Mickey and the One-Nighters. Because that was it, one night. But what a night it was. We sang a lot of rock and roll tunes, and we sang a lot of blues tunes. I'm going to do an old blues tune for you now that I remember my mom singing to me when I was still in the womb. It sounded different, of course. It sounded like... But I remember every note. I call it some of my pre-monkey singing, my PMS. When you just give love and never get love, you better let love depart. I know it's so, and yet I know I can't get you out of my heart. You made me leave my happy home. You took my love and now you're gone. For you, love brings such misery and pain. I guess I'll never feel the same since I fell for you. It's so sad that I'm in love with you. First you loved me, then you snubbed me. What can I do? I'm still in love with you. I guess I'll never see. I get the blues most every night since I fell for you.
One of the great pop voices of all times, Mr. Mickey Dolenz. And, strictly coincidentally, one of the great funny men of all time as well. At least he was yesterday. Today I haven't got a laugh out of him. I don't understand. But never mind. Unlike Mickey's household, my parents did not do much singing. My father sang a little bit around the house. My mother sang Broadway musicals very off-key. And my father played classical music on the turntables. You remember vinyl? Like that. Okay. So, yay, vinyl! Somebody's over there. That's good. So when this rock and roll thing came around, you have to understand I was very skeptical because I'd been raised in this other tradition. And also the fact that most of it, to my point of view at the time, sounded very much the same. In fact, it all sort of went like... That, you know, that kind of left me cold. I didn't really quite get it. Then the song that we're going to do next came around, and I have to tell you, Joshua at the Battle of Jericho did not bring the walls down as fast as this song broke my snobbish barriers to rock and roll. I mean, this was the one that converted me. I used to covet the radio and listen to the top 10 shows on television. I mean, just and buy the record, and just every chance I could get, I listened to this record. And the only reason I'm telling you this is because as a result of that, you know, early infatuation, I've lost all objectivity on the song. I have no idea whether it's any good or not. So if it... You know, if it means a hundredth or even a thousandth to you, what it meant to me, the evening is a smash guaranteed success. And if not, we'll be on to something else in 2 minutes and 17 seconds, so stick around, okay, for that? Thank you.
hey, hey, hey. A bit of blues and a bit of rock and roll. All right. The Monkeys Sing the Blues. That would be good, wouldn't it? Okay. All right. Well, I hope you're all having a good drink out there and enjoying yourselves. And I just went backstage and had a cup of tea. But drink a lot of alcohol, because this show's a lot better when you're drunk, okay? Wouldn't know about that myself, but... So listen, you know, we've been out here for about 10 minutes, 15 minutes now, and it'd be nice for you to know everybody else on the stage, so I'm going to introduce... First of all, what do you think about our dancing horn section back here? They're a breed of their own, those boys. Over here, this is Sam, this is Eric, and this is Gregory. Mind you, I'd be dancing around that if I was blowing the blood to my brain like that all the time. My goodness. Over here, she's absolutely fabulous. She's great. Yeah. She's teaching me how to play the saxophone. I'm going to blow it next time, aren't I? Good. Here's the deal. She plays the piano and she sings and she plays the saxophone and the flute and the clarinet. Her name is Miss Aviva Maloney. Hi, Maloney. Over here, this guy's all the way from New York City. He's a great guitar player. His name is Mr. Wayne Avers. Back here on the drums, this guy up here, he's played all over the world with a lot of people. His name is Mr. Sandy Gennaro. Okay, our musical director, the guy that leads the band, this is Mr. Jerry Ranino. And last, and certainly not least, the big man of the band, come out here for a minute. Look at the size of this guy here, look at this. Come on. Stop. This is a prime example. This is a prime example of ate the vegetables, didn't eat the vegetables. I can see right up your nose, you know. How tall are you, Annie? About 6'8", 6'9"?
6'2".
Man, you can't be 6'2". I'm 5'11 and a half, okay? No, he's a charming gentleman. This guy would give you the tent off his back, I'm telling you. He's fabulous. Well, the reason I got him out here is the same reason I'm going to get Sandy out here. Come here. This is going down on film, I'm telling you this now. Come here. Come on, no way. Slick your hair back there. Come on, son, put your hair back. You're going to be on the telly. Listen, here's what happens. When we're traveling around, right, don't fall on me or anything like that, will you? Jeez. Everything's big in America, isn't it? It's unbelievable. Unreal. Look at the size. Anyway. Hey, how you doing? All right? So, when we're traveling around on our bus, we have this massive big bus, okay? I get lost on it all the time. And what we do is, at the end of the evening, we go in the back of the bus and we have a lemonade. And we... Don't we have a lemonade? Yes. Right. Okay. And we mess about and we talk and we laugh and we play music and we watch videos. And the other night we were watching All in the Family, okay? Now, I kind of like that program. And I said to these guys, you know, what do you think about it? He said, oh, we could do that. So all of a sudden, he became Edith. He became Archie. Now, I want this on the show, okay? You know what I'm saying? Because I was laughing, mind, it was 4:45 in the morning and we're going into Paducah, Iowa or someplace, I don't know. And I was laughing on the floor. Can you do it again for me tonight? Okay, here's the deal. Edith and Archie, all in the family. Gloria is going to have a baby. So Edith, of course, this is Edith. She has to go up into the attic, right? She's going into the attic to get some supplies because Gloria's going to have a baby. Archie's waiting for his dinner, right? Okay, now do the Edith thing that he's doing. Right. Okay, go over there. Okay, you do the Archie, okay? All right? Just the Archie, okay? You got it? All right, here you go. You won't be long, just stay there.
Eat it! Eat it, Bunko! Gee, she always disappears at the wrong time.
You know, if they invented a pill for dingbats, she'd have a lifetime subscription over these. You know what I mean? Eat it. Eat it. Where you been, huh? Eat it. Please stop shaking. You look like a sack full of ferrets having a fight. Now eat it. I see a nice frosty beer glass there, you know, but there's no beer in it. I see a dinner plate, but there's no steak in it. Eat it over there. Now where have you been? Eat it all day long, huh?
Well, Archie, you know, Gloria just had the baby. So I was upstairs in the attic looking for the bassinet.
Bassinet? Oh, geez, you know he ain't old enough to play one of those yet. Now stifle yourself and get the beer on the table here, huh?
Dave Alexander, San Gennaro. Thank you. Follow that. I'm a brave man. Oh, goodness gracious, I'm so glad you thought that was funny. Oh, dear. Well, you know, Mickey and Peter were telling you about their priorities, their background. I actually, when I was a little tiny boy, this big, I used to watch Mickey Dolenz on Circus Boy, you know. Big fan. Of course, they're all much older than I am, those guys, you know. I'm glad, actually, when they asked me if I wanted to go back on the road with the Monkees, I said, sure, I thought they were dead. Only joking. Well, my background has been the theatre. I started off on the West End stage and then I went to Broadway. I was in a show called Oliver. I played the Artful Dodger. So at this particular part in our little show, what we normally do is do something from our past, but I want to just go back to the Monkees right now because this is a song that I haven't done in a long time. And I thought it'd be nice if we're going to have a little TV, a little special to sing this once again. It was a song written by Jerry Goldsmith. It's called It's Nice to Be With You. If you know the words, please don't sing along because it puts me off, okay? Hey, look what you have done. Showing me the... Hold it, wait a minute, hold it, wait, stop. Hey, what do you think you're doing? I'm singing a song here. You keep walking backwards and forwards all the time. Have you got a seat? Can you play music? Because I need a good musician up here. I'm not looking for trouble, I just want to know if you're lost. Hey, look what you have done. Showing me the sun. And now it's shining through. It's nice to be with you. Hey, I like the things you say, and I like the way you do the things you do. It's so nice to be with you. Time as I give my heart to someone new, well, they just turn it blue. On this time, in all the time I have to be with you, so it's so nice to be with you. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
listen to the band.
Thank you.
saw her face.
Thank you.